Once we know how to apply the VLOOKUP function, we also need to be aware that there is a better way, there is a more convenient way of referring to the source table. Okay, that means the table array. Instead of typing the reference, that means the cell reference, to show the range, we can use named range. So let us do it again. Let us do the VLOOKUP exercise again by using the named range instead of selecting the table array and locking and all this thing. Okay, so this can help us to avoid the mistake or error related to using the dollar sign or locking and all this thing. So what I will do now, I will delete this whole thing from here and do it again using the named range. So now let us start with VLOOKUP. Then lookup value is this one, and let me go a bit quicker because in the previous video I have explained in detail. Okay, so we'll look up this one, the month, and we don't want the column to be changed. Okay, now here is the point. What should be the table array? Okay, so we don't have any named range yet. So we have to come out of this, and at first we have to give a name to the table array so that we don't have to type the whole range and all this thing again. So what we'll do, we'll select this range of table and then click on this name field and type the name. So let us give a name. Let's say the name of this table is customer table. Customer credit table, something like that. Press enter. Oh, sorry, we don't have, we cannot include any space actually, I forgot. Anyway, so it can be something like that. Credit cell, something like that. Instead of space, I'm using underscore, okay? So this is the name of the, so now what we can do, we can start again, VLOOKUP, comma, the lookup value is the month, and we are going to lock the column, then comma, instead of table array, what we will do, we will type the name of the table array that we have just given. So what was the name? Credit cell. Okay, you can see the table has already been copied very easily, comma. Now column index number, just like before, so we don't want the row to be changed. Now range lookup is false, bracket close, finish. Now let us copy to the right and copy down, and let us check July value. In July you have the customer C and $500. Okay, that's fine. It's done. I hope that you have understood how to apply the VLOOKUP function with named range for the original table array from which we'll extract the data. Thank you for watching.